Hey everybody, I am back, and I hope you guys can see me because this is like take number 9 or something like that. The lighting has just been acting crazy, so I let down the garage and I'm doing it in the dark with the light on, and I can't see anything. It's completely like black, and I'm being blinded. So I know you guys are like excited and wondering like what happened and all that, or maybe you're not, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. So I didn't take the test when I said I was going to take the test. I actually waited 3 weeks because I kind of got spooked because of some problems that I came across on the practice exams. I didn't, you know, wasn't feeling comfortable about going in if it was on a test. So it wasn't even on a test. But anyways, I rescheduled like 3 weeks later, which is December 6th. So I took it December 6th and everything. And the bad news is I didn't freaking pass. I got a freaking 49. And I was just like, are you serious? Like 49. Not even like 40. You know, I probably would have felt better. But 49, like it fell right below. So I am kind of disappointed and everything. But the great news is that my recruiter said he can get it approved as, like, as if it was a 50, which is fine because there were some jobs that I kind of wanted, you know, that fell under 50. So, but the bad news is he said that I will have to be open to, I don't know if you guys can see me, it's hard to tell, but he said that I will have to be open to any single job that I qualify for. You go to fill out the jobs you want, you know, list the 10 at MEPS or whatever, or when you do job counseling or at BMT, I will have to be list every single one, and they can choose from any single one from top to bottom. I don't have a choice, and, you know, that would be that. And I didn't want to do that. I talked to some people, a few, some didn't respond, but I did talk to a few, and I told him, yeah, but he told me to take a day or two to call him back and let him know. So I just told him no because I really didn't know what else to do. I kind of wanted to, you know, reach out to you guys and make a video and ask, but it really was enough time, you know, a day to do that. So I just told him no, and I just want the retest, like, in 30 days. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to retest in 30 days. But one thing I was wondering is, like, are they really in the room, like, when you choose and when you're writing down your 10 jobs, do they get to see that list? Or, because I don't, you know, want to be disrespectful, and when he's, you know, saying we have a deal, and then, you know, he sees that I didn't follow through. So I was wondering if, you know, I could still, like, you know, only put, like, what I want, my 10 that I may want. Because I was watching Ebony Alexis, and what she was saying is that if you don't want a job, then don't put it on there at all. It's like, if you only want 5, only list 5, because they will still only pick out of those 5. So I was wondering, like, if I did something like that, you know, will he find out, will he know, or anything like that, or just when he see my job, he was like, oh, you got that, great. So if you guys know about that, if any of you guys that are depth in it may know, or if you just know the information to that, just let me know, you know, leave me a comment or inbox me or whatever, just, you know, to help me out some. And my goal was to be depth in by my 24th birthday, and my birthday was yesterday, December 12th. And obviously, you know, I'm not in, not depth in. So hopefully I can do that, you know, by the end of January, I'll be depth in. So there's still hope, you know. And I don't know if they changed them or not, but I know before, like, when you test, you have to wait 30 days if you miss it the first time. The second time, you have to wait 6 months. I don't know about the third time because, like, that would be sad, though. But I don't think I can wait 6 months. I don't know what I would do. Like, I would probably, like, yeah, I don't know, 6 months, and then I don't know how long I would be waiting to depth to ship out or whatever. It's just nerve-wracking. So I know that I have to work my butt off to pass this test in January 6th, so. And a site that I did found useful, and I didn't really start looking at it until 2 days before the test, was Khan Academy. That's Khanacademy. And it was listed in the video that I did of, you know, tips and helpful hints and stuff like that about taking the ASVAB. I think that was more, it would really help more than getting the ASVAB for dummies books or anything like that. You know, it's my preference. And then the prefix, suffix, and root words, just studying those because, you know, reading a dictionary is not gonna, you know, help you necessarily with the test. It may help you, you know, expand your vocabulary and writing and reading and speaking, but not on the test really. But the root words and suffix and stuff like that should help. So as far as an update with me, you know, I started working at Target about 3 weeks ago as a cashier just to, you know, have some change in my pocket, some gas in my car, you know, just until I ship out or, you know, something like that. And my fitness class ended yesterday. My final was to watch Food Inc. and, you know, do the regular testing, running. I sucked at my running. I did it in 10 minutes and like 9 seconds or something like that, a whole mile. And then I did 30 push-ups and 36 sit-ups, which I did better the second in the middle for the midterm part. So we did it three times, and I did like 40 something sit-ups and 35 push-ups, and I really did suck. And so it's kind of disappointing with that. But my final, we had to do a review and what we think and all that type of stuff on the movie Food Inc. It was like sickening to watch that movie. Like, oh, I supersized me. And to be honestly, when I first watched it, it made me hungry. I was like, somebody give me some McDonald's French fries. But, you know, I haven't had McDonald's in a long time, and I don't really eat beef. So, you know, I've been eating veggie burgers more, stuff like that. But the man. Watch that movie, watch that documentary. It's called Food Inc. You can watch it on YouTube. You can just type in, where can I watch Food Inc. online for free? Because I watch it online for free. And so that's pretty much it that's going on with me. So if you guys have any comments, questions, or, you know, any helpful hints, just, you know, inbox me, leave me a comment. As always, hopefully you guys are all doing what you have to do to get in, stay qualified, and all that good stuff. And I just got the letter back from when I got a parking ticket. I have to pay it. Great. And it came on my birthday too. Can you believe that? I must have did that on purpose. That was planned. So, yeah, happy holidays and Merry Christmas. Happy Kwanzaa, whatever you celebrate. Happy New Year's. And God bless. All right. So I'll talk to you guys later. I'll do an update. Probably in January. Okay, bye-bye.